The racks blue. What I'm supposed to do when these racks blue? Man, what's going on, Stacks TV, man? Back with another video, boy. Got my main dog in here.
King Richie, man. Y'all know what's going on, man. Like I said, man, go hit that subscribe button, man. King Richie TV, man.
Hey, Hot Box episode
don't play,
number
y'all.
Seven,
don't
y'all.
Play, man. Show that love and support, man.
Hey, Facts. Just to let y'all know, episode 6 is edited, it's finished, and ready to be uploaded. We just haven't uploaded it yet because, you know, it's been a little busy weekend and shit, but we definitely uploading it tonight. So make sure y'all stay tuned with that one. And tap in to episode 7 right now, so you feel me? But today's topic, though, what is it? Flaws, accepting your flaws, learning how to accept your flaws, and also, learn how to stop blaming other people for your problems and figure it out yourself, pretty much.
Facts.
Like, it's a lot of, not even trying to talk about people, but it's a lot of grown motherfuckers out here that's going around asking other people for answers and all this other shit about their lives. Like, you got to understand, bro, it's your life. It's your life to live, bro. So anything you make, any decision you make is based upon you, nigga, and what you want. You feel me? You control your own life, bruh. When we all realize it, man. I know y'all sleep. No, it's, you know, it's been going on for 400 years now. But sometimes you just got to think outside the box, bruh. And just ask yourself, like, why do certain shit happen like this? Right. Why is this like that? Why is this like that? If you don't walk around this earth, bruh, and question why certain shit ain't why it is, like, you feel me? Something wrong with you, bruh. And not even saying, like, oh, no, dumb, retarded shit. It's just really something wrong,
man,
with you. Like,
something
bro.
Wrong with you mentally, man. If you just don't sit down, man, to ask yourself, like, what can I do to stop these fucking bad vibes following me? I'm going to tell you. Cut off the bad motherfuckers that's around you, man. Cut off the motherfuckers that got their brain negative. Don't never have nothing positive to talk about. Always got something negative to throw up or just bring that bad energy around me. Y'all gotta cut them niggas off, man. Straight like that, man.
Hey, and then again, I say, it's more so like, I more so feel like, man, it's really pretty much you. Like, bro, you gotta realize, like, nigga, what are you doing wrong? First of all, that's the question, bro.
Exactly.
What are you doing wrong, bro, in your life that's, you know, you feel like you keep fucking it up? Because it's something that you're doing wrong. It's something that you're not doing right. So that's what you should think, like, oh, yeah, let me go back to the blueprint. Let me go back to the drawing board and shit and figure out what the fuck I'm doing wrong so I could get shit right. But, I mean, shit will never get right because that's just the life we live in. You feel me? Shit will never be right. You always going to have ups and downs. And that's what I feel. That's what I think people fail to realize, because a lot of motherfuckers get some bad times and shit and want to cry and boo-hoo. But not realizing, like, damn, bro.
Right.
When it rain, nigga, don't the sun always come back out? It always come back out and get way warmer than what it was.
So, that's nigga, facts, though, man.
You feel me? You be down for a minute, but
yeah, man. But the comeback be twice as harder.
Twice
man,
as
every
harder.
Time.
Because you stay down, you stay strong, and you told yourself, like, bro, I never fall on wayside, nigga, no matter how bad it get. You feel me?
Word of advice, too, man. For that topic right there, man. Another thing to do, y'all, man. Stop looking at every situation that y'all go through as like bad luck
or the devil messing with you.
You know what I'm saying? Sometimes just really look at, like, I used to be like that. Like, say for instance, what can I use as an example, man? Like, I'll go to the store. My intentions would be to go to the store, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'll be on my way to the store. I get the engine cranked up and everything, man. Boom. Next thing you know, my tire flat. Now, instead of being pissed, going off like, God damn, I mean, even though, you know, that's some fucked up shit that happened, but either way it go, sometimes just try to take the positive side of it. Like, just think, like, man, maybe God was stopping me from going to the gas station at that moment because maybe somebody was about to shoot that motherfucker up or something. You know what I'm saying?
Or
just stop turning everything negative and start turning even the negative shit to positive, bro. And watch doors open up for you, bro. Watch everything start changing, bro. It ain't gonna happen like this overnight, but long as you keep doing, like, you know what I'm saying? Just
keep
have faith, bro.
Part,
keep
man.
Doing what you doing, bro. You know what I'm saying? And just believe, bro. And like Von said, man, have faith, man. And y'all shit gonna come through for y'all, man. Best believe that, man.
Real talk. For sure that.
But yeah, don't never, you know what I'm saying, don't never put all your eggs in one basket too, though. That's another thing. A lot of y'all tend to count on one thing, you know what I'm saying? Like, oh, I'm about to get this job.
Or somebody.
So you just stop trying and you stop applying yourself just because this job then called you back and was like, yeah, you can start Monday. Don't necessarily mean nothing. Because I know a lot of motherfuckers that didn't start it. And then they application, they got pulled, talking about, so they ain't need them like how they thought they needed them. So,
right, so
end up losing that bitch all over again. Now you right back to square one, but you could have had like at least like 2 to 3 jobs lined up if that one didn't work out. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, y'all, man, just think, man, before y'all do anything y'all do, man, before y'all, you know.
Realize it always come back to you, bro.
Facts, man.
Always come back to you. Everything you do always come back to you. That's facts. Why when people say, nigga, karma, when you do bad, nigga, karma come back around. That shit true.
Hell yeah, man. That's why you can't do no fuck shit to nobody out here nowadays, bro. Because if it don't come back to necessarily you, bro, it's going to come back to somebody that you really, really care about, bro. And either they going to get sick as fuck and God going to be calling them home. And that shit gonna fuck with you the long way. Like, that shit ain't gonna never leave your conscience, cause you know, like, all you gonna be thinking about is, damn, what did I do fucked up to deserve to be going through this that I'm going through right now?
You did.
And you gonna be thinking about all the fuck shit you done did, to whether it was people or just did in general, brother. However you know what I'm saying, whatever you doing, man, just y'all gotta stop that, man. And just like I said, man, it ain't nothing wrong with going to work, bro. Like, what's the one rapper name, man? He just admitted, man. He was on, he was doing an interview with the nigga No Jumper and shit, bro. The new, what is that nigga name? Not No Cap,
No Plug?
No. Little light skin. I don't even listen to him. That's why I really don't even know his name for real. But crazy looking motherfucker. Got the gold teeth in his mouth. Tats all on his neck. Wear the do-rag and shit. I don't know. Whatever the case may be, man. Just... y'all know, man. Just don't put all y'all eggs in one basket, man.
You feel what I'm saying, man? That's real game to you. And then another thing, bro. Stop blaming yourself, bro. Stop blaming yourself, nigga. Well, stop blaming yourself, but stop blaming other people for your problems and shit.
Right.
Sometimes you gotta realize, nigga, it's not always best for you to go and run and tell people. Soon as something happened, nigga, or if anything happened in your life, because sometimes, nigga, everything don't have to be, you know, said. You feel me? Some shit you can keep to yourself, but a lot of people can't hold that weight. That's why I say, nigga, I don't know. It's just, like, crazy nowadays, because it's, like, in order for you to feel good about yourself, you got to go talk to somebody.
You got to impress another nigga. Like, come on.
Or, like, not even that, though. That like, you just got to... like, they make it seem like you crazy or, like, you need help. And that's where depression, anxiety, and shit come from, bro. Like, you got to understand, like, you got all the answers, bro. You got all the answers.
You just
got
to find them.
You
got to,
you know, connect with your higher self, bro.
Facts.
They just got to be on the same vibration, bro.
But with that being said, too, though, not to sit there and say, because... although, like, man, I hope whoever listening to this video, man, y'all really take everything that me and Von saying into consideration for real. But at the same time, too, we don't know everybody's situation. So if you just so happy, you know what I'm saying, to be going through a real, real fuck. Like I was saying, though, y'all, man, we don't know everybody's situation, man, what everybody going through. Like I said, everybody's story and background is different, man. So
but you gotta
some people do actually... have it rougher than other people, you know what I'm saying? But that just means that you gotta go harder, you know what I'm saying? That just means you got something bigger ahead for you, man.
That's what I told y'all the
most. God not gonna put you through nothing that you can't handle, you know what I'm saying? He gonna, you know what I'm saying? It's just up to you, man. He gonna put in 50% of the work for you. You just gotta put in the other 50%, man. That's it.
That's just how the game go, bro. If you want something done,
that go for everybody,
you gotta go do it yourself, bro.
That go for everybody, man. Whatever you do, about, man, just put your all into it.
A lot
it,
about
man.
Black kids and queens out here, 2020, bruh. I feel like everybody should just go for their own business, bruh. If you gonna keep your job and shit, that's cool and all. But like, I feel like all black people should just shoot for a straight business, bro. Whether if it's a clothing line, nigga, open a gas station store, nigga, clothing store, nigga, whatever you want to do, bro. We should just all try to shoot for that shit, bro. And just,
yeah, whether nigga, it's individual or if you got a team, come together as a team, man. Sit down at the round table, the square table, other, nigga, the whatever fucking other, table, nigga, man, and just discuss, man, about me? What y'all can
if
do.
If I come out with some shit, nigga, I'm definitely gonna promote my shit always and forever, nigga. Facts. I'm never gonna rock another nigga and get another nigga richer and shit. That's what a lot of people fail to realize. Like, y'all getting all these other people richer and shit. I mean, yeah, it's cool. The shit look good and shit. But sometimes, nigga, you think about it, you be like, damn, bro, I could start my own shit. Facts. Had niggas going crazy over my shit. You feel me?
Facts.
And get paid at the same time. Like, y'all got to think about that shit. That shit ain't going nowhere. But shit, really, yo shit, you got to think about it. It's your shit. So that shit going to generate forever. You feel me?
Facts.
Long as you keep that motherfucker up, it's together.
Don't let nobody knock y'all off y'all grind either, man. Like I was saying, it don't matter. When I say it don't matter how y'all get it, I don't give a fuck if you was sweeping hair at the motherfucking barber shop, bro. As long as you flipping that shit, bro, don't worry about what the next nigga say. Oh, I got a nigga, I work at Amazon. Nigga, it turns out I heard from a lot of people that I just so happen to know, man. You nigga, that ain't even all what it's caked up to be for real, man. So, like I said, it really don't matter what job you working, man. It's how you finessing the bread, man. And how you with investments and what you putting that shit into for real, man. And bring more income, you know what I'm saying? Because if you really want to get it, but I'm going to tell you one thing right now, too, y'all. For one, if you don't know, you should know that. If you ever do want to be really comfortable in life, bro, it's definitely going to take more than one hustle, bro. You can't just hustle one thing either and just think you're going to, you know, just because I'm standing down on this one hustle.
You feel me?
That I should be able to come up. You know what I'm saying? It's not going to happen like that, man. You always got to have at least like a good solid 2 to 3 grinds, bro. You got to.
That's the only way you're going to be able to scratch. Like, if you can scratch.
Especially if you got a family.
If you can scratch with one job, nigga, toodles to you, but nigga. Man, majority of niggas, bro, you gotta have that hustle, bro. You gotta have that hustle.
Yes, sir. Because I know a lot of motherfuckers now, you know, it's snowing in Cleveland right now, y'all. It could be sunny one day, next day it's snowing. I don't know. This Cleveland weather up and down, though, y'all. For the viewers, that's, if you from Cleveland and you watching this video, y'all already know what's up. But make a long story short, though, man. A lot of niggas still discouraged out here to get out here with the shovel, man, and go knock on the elderly. It ain't even gotta be, you know what I'm saying, just any door, just people that y'all know, like on y'all old street, like
show love,
right? Like, you know, let me shovel your driveway for the fire, you know what I'm saying? Because you know the city taxing,
right?
The city, they coming up, they plowing your shit in like 10 seconds and they charge you a whole 50 just to plow your shit. When you know what I'm saying,
you got a little rah rah around the corner, nigga, with a whole shovel or probably a plow truck, nigga.
That's what the young motherfucking generation need to be doing. That's what y'all young black men need to be doing, bro. Y'all need to stop worrying about flashing these Gucci belts and flexing at school, man. Get out here and get some real paper, man. So by the time y'all hit 21, y'all can be up, bro.
Advice to all y'all youngins, though, nigga. We come from, nigga, the hard side of Cleveland, nigga, the up the way side, nigga. So it was like way different from, nigga, East Cleveland and motherfucking down the way and all that shit in the west side. But, like, niggas saying, like, niggas ain't even trying to compare, but, like, man, just seeing the little niggas grow up, bro, and me becoming who I am, nigga, and me being older now, it make me look like, damn, like, the OGs, nigga, we ain't really had them OGs and shit like that, you feel me, when we was growing up, so, nigga, we trying to look at it like, we gotta be them niggas. Yeah. We gotta be them niggas to help the youth.
But you gotta have, some of y'all do got OGs, but they ain't the right OGs,
they not the right ones.
For real, man. Mm-hmm. They ain't telling you to go to school, man, and stay down, get the paper, bro, or showing you how to do it, bro. Nigga, them niggas, ain't no point even talking to them niggas, bro.
Hey, if it ain't about money, what they talking about?
Seriously, bro.
All you niggas pity pitching this shit at the gas station, man. Think about it, bro. If y'all put that money together, nigga, go buy some tools or something, nigga. Or go buy a couple lawnmowers or weed whackers and shit from around the hood, nigga. Y'all put that together, y'all can start y'all all little shit. Going around cutting niggas' grass and shit. Y'all get up with that shit, nigga. Y'all could probably turn that into something bigger or better. You feel me? It's ways out here, bro.
Facts.
easy ass ways. And then nowadays, bro, it's so easy because it's easy to promotion on Instagram and all this other shit.
Niggas scared to, get called a lame just because you cutting somebody else's grass. How's you a lame? Well, if they paying you, right?
They pay you.
Ain't they paying you?
You make it, might not be dope, you make your money, but right? Nigga, it's still
how you a lame?
It's gonna still stack up. Cause
you walking around with a lawnmower, bro.
It's gonna stack
and
up.
Honestly, that money is faster than the illegal money, truthfully, because
it is.
Cause
but with that illegal
you
money,
you know what I'm saying?
A lot of niggas be like with that illegal money though, nigga. Niggas spend that shit quicker because you get it back like so fast like that, bro. So niggas don't think and niggas try to blow that shit quick. Like, oh yeah, I got the bag, nigga. I'm cool, nigga. I'll be straight, nigga. I'll get another bag. But like, you fella realize, nigga, that shit go fast, nigga. That shit go fast, bro.
Because
y'all niggas do not know how to manage y'all money. And it's a lot of niggas that's not, man. I ain't about to keep repeating myself, brother. Yo, I think it's dope.
Facts, though, man. But for real, though, man, think about what y'all do, man, before y'all do it, man. With everything, though, like.
And then another thing, man, I'm going to definitely tap in way more, probably episode 8, but I just wanted to touch bases on, like, motherfucking relationships and shit. Like, a lot of people I be seeing on social media, every time I get on social media, like, I see us black men bashing the females and shit, calling them out their name and shit, just dogging them and shit, saying all types of
shit.
Yeah,
that shit corny, though.
Vice versa, nigga, the females dogging us and shit. And it's just crazy, like, how the white people got us so divided now. Like, you look over there and you see nigga motherfucking smiles, hugs, and kisses and shit. The whites be forgiving them niggas. It's just unity
but
over
honest,
there. Like,
honestly,
like
though,
they tried to really divide us so bad, bro. And it's just so sad
and it,
to
but
see
honestly,
that shit,
though,
bro.
Sad to say, it worked. Because, unfortunately, you got way more dumb niggas out here than you do got.
You think a male alpha nigga and his precious flower queen, bro, together, nigga, man, it would be so motherfucking crucial, bro, because y'all could probably double up even faster.
Look, I
want to like
say
that,
this,
nigga.
Bro.
They hate to see niggas together,
motherfucking
man. And it ain't even nothing wrong. A lot of y'all niggas, bro, be portraying this motherfucking bro. Music or whatever the fuck y'all niggas be thinking and shit.
Man,
females,
what?
Too, bro. They got these female artists out here and shit saying that you don't need a nigga. You could be independent and shit. I mean, yeah, that's cool. You get your own bag. But at the same time, ain't shit wrong with a man holding it down,
hell
nigga.
No, that's how
ain't
it's supposed
wrong.
To be.
That's how it's supposed to be. But they train niggas.
If you a college
niggas,
graduate, bro.
They
if
train
your third
niggas,
eye not opening, you don't realize what the fuck
niggas,
is going on, bro.
They train
you
niggas.
You dumb.
They
you
train
dumb.
Niggas
care,
to think
dumb,
and believe
bro.
That you don't need a man, bro, in order to get up in life. Which, I mean, you could do what the fuck you want to do. Ain't nobody trying to tell you what you can and can't do. But y'all got to realize, nigga, male don't try to be controlling, nigga. Sometimes we know best. And it's mm-hmm. true because it's always facts, though, nigga. We always know best, bro. Because
it's a man's instinct, though, bro.
Just like y'all got the same thing about us. Y'all feel like, nigga, we dog y'all and shit, be like y'all trying to be our mother and shit the same way. Not saying that, nigga, males in a motherfucking cool, none of that shit, nigga, because we do the same shit, nigga. Y'all try to baby us and shit, saying, no, you can't do this, you can't do that. I don't think you should do that. And that's just how we should feel, too. We got to respect that, too.
Right, see, that's
because
my thing,
she probably
bro.
Might know best for me.
I respect my baby mama. Because
she know
I,
you.
I listen
already,
to,
she know you more than anybody,
I listen to what
bro.
She
say
sometimes,
feel me?
Though. Like,
you
I
got
to,
bro.
For sure.
You
it's
got
vice
to.
Versa, bro. You got to have that connection.
And that's what y'all feel to realize, nigga. I don't know what social media have did to y'all niggas, but marriage is really a thing, bro. You really, if you going to marry somebody, bro, you really got to, you know, say them vows, bro, and really own up to that shit, you feel me? Ain't no turning back, no none of that, because y'all need to take that shit more serious. It's just not for the looks. It's not for the weddings. Most of y'all, I feel like it's for the weddings, but that's just me, though. That's just how I feel, but hey, what do I know? But who gives a fuck, though, bro? Y'all got to think about this shit, bro, because
yeah,
niggas really saying some real shit.
But no,
we
man.
Need each other.
Vine, I don't know. I forget what video you said this shit in, but when you mentioned a comment about how niggas be really out here dancing for other niggas, man, that shit fact, man. Like, why is you telling another nigga, hey, record me, do this real quick, bro, that you know really ain't your niggas, though. That's the thing. You know what I'm saying? Bro, them niggas laughing at you. They not laughing with you,
My
bro.
Question is, why do niggas go to work to make friends, though? That's what I always see in work spots. Like, it's like a bad energy. It's like a bad
vibe. It's like
vibe
school. It's like high school all spot. Over
yes,
again,
it
bro.
It is, bro.
It's
but really just like older school, motherfuckers, bro.
Exactly,
and they even
bro.
Worse. Niggas be laughing in each other's faces, but come up to you, tapping you on your shoulder, be like, man, this nigga, bro, he be on some other shit, bro. I don't really fuck with this nigga.
Facts.
And then go back and laugh in his face and shit. Like, bro, that shit's so weird.
But not man enough to talk about
like
you.
Like the nigga
your
right
face,
there.
Though. They gonna talk
he
about
right
you
there.
To another coworker, man. Niggas ain't gonna say nothing to your face. Cause that's you know what I call that? That's a coward. You a coward,
bro, pretty much.
That's just all it is to it.
That shit fried though, bro. I don't get that.
No, you a straight cop.
Niggas gotta figure that shit out, bro. For real. But shit. Top of that, man, that's probably gonna be the end of this, man. Y'all can check us out.
Yeah.
On motherfucking
King Richie TV, man. Y'all already know, man.
Y'all can check me out on Instagram at Stacks TV. It will be down below.
Yes, sir.
Follow me on Instagram. Follow me on Twitter. I'm active on all platforms as well. So, you know, if you follow me and shit, I'll follow you back. Tap in with me, bruh. Send me some suggestions y'all want to hear about. Y'all got some, you feel me? Y'all got some questions and shit. We'll do some answers, Q&As, whatever y'all want to do. Let us know.
Facts. Like I said, if y'all want to tune in, man. My life, man, King Richie, man, you know what I'm saying? Just
man.
Go on YouTube, man. It's not hard, you know, just type in King Richie, man. Hit that search button, man. Like I said, if you don't even hit that subscribe button, please hit that like button, man. So, with that being said, man,
peace out, y'all.